Hi everyone, this is Kevin here, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you tips and tricks for the bold N1. So let's get started. So this is the bold N1. You can currently buy this phone on Bold's website for a promo price of $199. You can also get this on Amazon for $249.99. And once that Bold website promo is over, the permanent price tag for the device will be $249.99. Now it is possible the price might go down over time, so definitely take a look at the link in the video description to see the most up-to-date pricing. Now let's go over the tips. So the first tip I want to show you is related to the screen rotation. So typically, I like to turn off auto-rotate because I don't like everything to always auto-rotate when I'm using the phone. But sometimes, if you do want things to rotate, you don't really want to go all the way up here and tap on auto rotate again. So what you need to do is make sure auto rotate's off. Then, when you're in an app like Chrome, and you're on an article like this one, you'll see that when you turn the display to the side, things do not auto rotate. And that's normal. That's the way we want it. But there's this thing that pops up on the side here, and essentially if you tap on that button, it will rotate the display. So things are now rotated, then if you move things back into the vertical position, it will not auto-rotate again, but you can then tap on that button again to rotate things back to the portrait rotation. So definitely a cool trick there that I personally wasn't aware of until I did some research. Now the Bold N1 does have a pop-up camera on the top, and if you didn't know this, you can actually pick the different sound effects that you want to give to that pop-up camera. So what you need to do is pull down the shade, go to your settings, go to sound, and then go down to other sounds and vibrations. Then there's an option down here that says camera pop-up sound. So you get several different options. There's mute, so if you don't want a sound, you can check that off. There's sci-fi, machine, and rhythm. So we'll try out sci-fi. So that's pretty cool. But we're gonna put it back on mute. So if you're wanting to change the sound of your camera pop-up, then here you go. Another interesting trick that you can actually do on pretty much every phone that runs Pi is that if you wanna go to your previously used app, you don't actually have to tap on this button here and then go over to that app. Instead, all you have to do is just double tap on the recent apps button and it'll take you over right away to your previously used application. Now, another interesting thing here is that you can actually turn the screen locking sounds on or off. So right now it's off. So when I turn the screen off or on, it doesn't make any noise at all. But then if I turn that back on, you can hear there that it does have screen locking and unlocking sounds. And what's funny is these sounds are exactly the same as they are in iOS. There's also additional options here for charging sounds, touch sounds, and there's a sound enhancement option which you can turn on to boost the volume from the speaker. So another great option there to increase the sound loudness from the phone. Another trick I want to inform you about is how to make the fingerprint sensor more accurate. So as it is, it works pretty well for me. It's pretty accurate. I don't really have any big complaints with the fingerprint sensor on the Bold N1. But if you are having issues, or if you just want to make things even better, a nice trick is that you can actually go over to security and location, which is where the options for the fingerprint sensor are, and you can add additional fingerprints for the same finger. So the more fingerprints you add for the same finger, the more accurate the fingerprint sensor will be, and the quicker you'll be able to unlock your phone. Now for this next trick, you're gonna pull down the shade, you're gonna go to developer options. Once you're in settings, tap on about device, then go down to build number, tap on that several times, and then you activate developer mode, then put in your PIN, and now developer mode has been activated. So now that you've activated developer options, go to the settings and type in DEV, and then you'll see developer options right there, just a nice shortcut to get to that. Then you're gonna go down until you see feature flags, and then you're gonna wanna turn on Bluetooth while driving. So what this does is that it gives you the option so that you can activate Bluetooth while driving, And what Bluetooth while driving is that when the phone senses that you're driving, it will automatically turn on Bluetooth so that you can connect to the Bluetooth system in your vehicle. So now that Bluetooth while driving has been enabled, you're going to go back. You're going to go all the way back. Then on the Bluetooth setting, go there. And then you're now going to see use Bluetooth when driving. Turn that on. And then when you're driving, Bluetooth will turn on. Now this next trick is kind of more of a gimmick, I suppose, but still something that's kind of interesting to see. So what you're going to do is that since you have developer options already enabled, you're going to go to your settings again, type in DEV to find developer options, go to developer options, then go down until you see simulate a display with a cutout. And then you can actually add a notch to your device. So you can do a tall display cutout and it'll add kind of like a taller notch at the top. You can do a corner display cutout. You can add a notch to the corner. Or you can do a double display cutout and it adds a notch to the top and bottom. Definitely more of a gimmick there, but also something interesting so that you can know really what you're missing out on if you were to have a notch with the phone. Now, thankfully, this phone doesn't need a notch because it has a pop-up front-facing camera. But in case you're ever wondering what this phone would look like with a notch, you can add one through that feature and see what it looks like on the phone. And since this is an AMOLED display, the actual notch itself is super dark, so it's actually really hard to tell that that's even part of the display. It almost looks like it's part of the bezel. And finally, the last thing I want to show you is very important. Some people forget about it. I know that it's probably a feature that you're not surprised even exists, but that is to check your app permissions. So pull down the shade, go to your settings, then go down to apps and notifications. And then from here, you'll see app permissions. Tap on that. And then you'll see which applications are allowed to use which features on the phone. So you can see which apps have access to your contacts. So for me, all of these ones do. And then you can toggle which ones you want to turn off and maybe which ones you want to turn on. Another big one that I know a lot of people are concerned about pretty often is the microphone. They want to know which apps can listen to them. So tap on microphone and you can see that the camera can listen to you, which makes sense because it's the camera, but Google, Instagram, messages, and the phone. So if you feel uncomfortable with one of these apps listening to you, then you can just turn it off. And then when you ever need to use the microphone again in the future, maybe if you're recording a video, for example, for Instagram, you can always re-enable it later on. But I hope you enjoyed these tips and tricks for the Bold N1. If you found this video to be helpful, I can always make a follow-up to it with more tips and tricks. But I just wanted to give you a nice taste of the different tips and tricks available for the phone. But if you do want to purchase this phone, take a look at the link in the video description. But let me know what you think of the Bold N1, and let me know if you have any other suggestions for tips and tricks for the device. And I'll see you in the next video.